In today's video, I am going to show you how to change the color of one menu item, whether it's in your main menu, your sub menu, or your footer. And it is brought to you by a viewer's question from my previous video on header menu and size color. So this video here, where I'm showing you how to change the colors of a menu and also the sizes if you want to change the size of the font. And so the question is, can we change one item color, like only a sale option in red and rest in black? I think is what they meant. So that is what this video is about today. So let's head over to our Shopify dashboard. Now I'm going to be using Dawn 14. I have tested this in the 14, the Dawn Sense and Craft, and it all works up until version 10. So if you have a version, you know, anything older than a 10, this may or may not work. So just giving you a heads up. In this video, I'm going to show you how to find the code so that you're able to make these customizations yourself. So if it doesn't work, you know, I'm showing you the process. Okay. So this is what we're doing today. We're just changing the color of one item like we see here. We're going to do your main menu, your sub menu, and also your footer. Okay. So let's get started. So what you'll do here is we're going to come into edit code, right? And always remember, if we are changing anything in your code and your website is live, go ahead and make a duplicate. So if you just head over to the ellipsis here and click on duplicate, it will make a duplicate copy and it'll post it down here. And then you can come into the edit code and go ahead and make those changes there without disturbing your live website. Okay, so always do that. Better safe than sorry. So what you'll do here in your code editor, we're going to come down to where it says assets. Now, I always forget to mention, for this particular theme, and again, we're doing Dawn 14, it is the base CSS. And for your theme, it could be theme.css. It could also be style.css. And also, depending on how old your theme is, it could be theme.scss. I have to say that slow. All right, so we're going to go to the base CSS. And what you'll do is here, you come all the way down to the very bottom. And here is the code that I've already used to make these changes here and in my sub menu right here. Okay. And if you like my little cursor right here, this is so much fun. If you want to add a cursor like this onto your website, go ahead and check out this video here. And I'll also post it at the end of the video as well. The snippet to add a cursor is currently free, so I'll link it there and go ahead and take advantage of it. I just had so much fun creating this. I made this for the 4th of July. All right. So let's go back here. So this is the code that we have used, right? So what I'm going to show you is how to do this for yourself. I don't want you to have to just copy and paste. I want to empower you to show you how I find this code. Okay. So what you'll do here on your website, right click and then hit the inspect tool. So that we're going to go into the inspect tool, because what we want to do is that we want to isolate an individual menu item, right? We don't want to make them all red. We just simply want to make maybe one. So let's say for the viewer's question was, if this was sale, we want the sale to be in red or whatever color you want that to be. Okay. All right. So in order to do that, what you'll do is you come to this little cursor right here to select an element. Okay. So you're going to click on that element there, and then you're going to hover over the menu item that you want to change. Okay. So you don't want to come all the way down here to the span. What you want to do is you want to hover right over until you see where it says name dark roast. Okay. So once you click on main.roast, you'll see here on the right hand side that that section is highlighted for us. So what you'll do here is you'll right click, and then you're going to go ahead and copy, and then copy selector. Okay. So we're going to copy the selector. Then we're going to head back. This is a great time for you to have multiple windows open. So you're going to head back here to the theme editor. Okay. But I already have this one, so I want to show you another one. So let me click on the medium roast. All right. And then we're going to go ahead and click on that. And then we'll add it right here. So we're going to paste what you just copied. This is what it's going to produce here for you. And just like you see in this code here, then we'll have some curly brackets. Right. And then here you'll add the color. So this is the color that we want. right? And then we're going to go ahead and use red so it stands out and you can see that. And then what you wanted to do is that you want to write important. And the reason that you want to write important is that you want, there's a lot of code back here. This is what all this is. And you want to make sure that you want to tell your web browser that this code is important and needs to override any other color that's already set. Okay, so that's what this is saying. So that's really it. That's all there is to this code. Now you're going to click on save. Right, we're going to head back over here and we're going to refresh. And now the medium rows has been changed, right? Super simple, super cool. Right now, if you wanted to put bold, see, I put bold here for the dark rows, then you just simply press enter, and then you'll just type here, as I did here, font weight, and then bold, okay? So that's how you can make those changes here. And then you're going to do the same thing for your mobile, because this is only going to make the changes to the desktop menu. It will not make a change to the mobile. Okay, so what you'll do here, again, you're going to right click and click on inspect. We'll come right over here. If you see this little option here to toggle your device, it's gonna make it into a mobile, right? And if you click on the menu, you'll see that the red has not affected the dark rows on the mobile. Okay, so we're going to do the same exact thing. You're gonna click on the select element. You're going to hover until you see where it says medium roast is the name. Then you're going to head over here, right click, copy, copy selector. I'm going to head over back over here, header drawer, and do the same thing. We're going to do some curly brackets, color. Let's do red and then important. Save that. And let's head over and let's refresh. And there we are. There is our medium roast. Okay, so that's how you do your main menu for mobile and desktop. Now let's do the accessories, which is a drop-down menu. And it's gonna be the same process. So you're going to click on the actual menu and then the same thing. You can click on this element here, highlight it. We're gonna do the T this time, right? Then again, copy your selector and do the same thing, right? And as you can see from the pattern, right, you're going to actually do header drawer and then accessories, and there is no space in code. So you're going to do accessories, and the 4T lovers is going to have the hash in between. Okay, so the header, the drawer is your mobile, and then header menu is your desktop. Okay, so if you want to write it out, you can certainly do that. So let's go ahead and finish this up. I wanted to go ahead and just show you how to do this using the inspector to empower you to make those changes and see where it is that, you know, we're getting these codes from, right? All right, so now we'll go ahead and refresh. And let's go to our submenu, and there we are. All right. All right, so now the last one is going to be our footer. So if you want to make those changes to our footer, let's come down here. And guess what? It's the same exact thing. And actually, for the footer, you only need one code. All right, so let's go ahead and click on my selector here. Let's go ahead and do the light roast. All right, see how it's highlighted here? We'll go into our copy our selector. And again, let's bring it down here. And as you can see, it's a much longer code. No worries, it's exactly the same. So you're gonna go all the way to the end of that code, press enter. Okay, so you're gonna hit a curly bracket. You're gonna do your color, colon. The color that you want, you can certainly use your hex color instead of just the name of the red, just to stick to your brand color, you would use your hex color, but I'm going to go ahead and just use the name red. We'll save there and let's go ahead and refresh and let's take a look at our mobile. And there we go. Our light rose is there for the mobile and also for the desktop. And that is it. So if you want to learn how to change your menus into lowercase, uppercase, or capitalized, go ahead and check out this video next. Or if you want to go ahead and add these fun cursors as well to your website, then check out this video here. Until next time, my friend. Adios.